Okay, so we're here today to talk about the new Samsung HTQ air source heat pump. It's the latest in the Samsung range. As you can see, there's a new design. It's nice, sleek, dark design. They've actually lowered the unit. A lot of their previous units were quite tall, so if you're trying to get it under a window, you wouldn't. So they've made it quite a lot shorter. The kind of the trade-off for that is it's quite a lot deeper. So most air source units are about a third of a meter. This is, I think, just shy of a meter, about 600, 700, 800 mil, something like that. Aside from that, it's going to work in quite a similar way to what you're used to with Samsung. It's still going to have the same reliability, still going to have a 7-year parts and labor warranty through us. What's different is it will achieve a higher output, but it will also achieve the sort of a truer output, if you like. So with the previous Samsung, a 16 kilowatt unit would actually drop down to about 12 and a half or so, a 12 kilowatt unit would drop down to about 10 and a half or so. So they'd always have this drop off in colder weather, whereas the new range, so an 8, a 12 and a 14, I believe, they will all achieve those outputs. So no matter what the temperature does outside, it will maintain the higher efficiency and it will also maintain those higher outputs. So, you know, a 14 is a true 14 these days, which is good from my point of view because it makes sense. So installation wise, it's going to be the same as any other heat pump you're used to. The difference is largely aesthetics on the external unit. You know, they look good. The grills have actually been designed in a particular angle so that when you're above or in front, you can't really see through the grill so easily. Which I think is quite a thing with planners. For some reason, planning departments don't really like being able to see inside a heat pump. They have a quiet mode. So in the quiet mode, I think it's about 30% reduction in output, but it is much, much quieter. It takes the noise level down to about 30 odd decibels, which is about half the rating of a normal unit. And decibels is a bit misleading. For every 3 decibels up you go, you actually double the perceived noise output from a unit. So to be able to reduce it down by sort of 20 or so decibels noise rating is actually a massive impact. You know, if you're trying to get through a particular planning regulation or whatever, then, you know, obviously you've got that quiet mode option. So they're called the HT units because they're high temperature. So these units are able to achieve an output of up to 70 degrees without any immersion or anything like that, purely based on the compression cycle. While we're not going to run a system at that temperature, we don't believe in running heat pumps at such a high temperature because it's not very efficient. The fact they're able to do that is quite a boon. The highest flow temperature to space heating that you're allowed for MCS is 55 degrees, which presumably would be to a radiator system. So what's the point of having a heat pump that can go up 70 if you're never going to use it at that? It's the knock-on effect is better performance. It's a bit like, you know, if you get a Porsche that can do 200 miles an hour or whatever, you're never going to be able to drive it at that speed because, well, you'll be breaking the law, so you're obviously not going to do that. But you get a better performance out of the car at the lower speeds because of all the engineering that goes into that at the top end. So the reheat time, the reaction time of the heat pump is going to be much quicker, and just, you know, a gradual improvement on performance at the lower levels. And the fact that it can maintain the higher level outputs, I think, is quite a boon. So the 14 HTQ actually gives a higher output than the 16 EHS, the previous model. So, you know, it is a step up. It is an improved unit. So these will come in an 8 kilowatt, 12 kilowatt and 14 kilowatt. They're more or less available immediately. As with most things, we're going to be stocking them. We don't like keeping people hanging around while we're waiting for deliveries to come in from elsewhere. So we're going to try and keep as much in stock as possible as usual. But as I say, the 8 will give you 8, the 12 will give you 12, and the 14 will give you 14 kilowatts. So it is different to a lot of the other ones. Where they differ from some of the other ones that we stock, for example, a, you know, major competitor has a 14 kilowatt unit, is about 1.366 centimeters tall, 1.4 meters. So getting it under windows is quite a big thing for a lot of people. You know, if you can have a single fan unit or a lower unit, you can't see the back of it through your kitchen window or whatever, you know, that's much more preferable to a lot of people. They're going to be a few hundred quid more than the standard Samsungs, but I think the looks of it and everything else, it does kind of justify that. A lot of people also ask us about introducing Hive or Nest controls, where you've got a kind of a whole house BMS kind of system, to a building management system, to control everything from a central hub. Really all those do with a heat pump usually is provide a glorified on-off function. So you can use them, there's no issue whatsoever, you can always use them. With Samsung, you can actually use their SmartThings app. So if you've got your Samsung phone, your Samsung fridge, your Samsung washing machine, what have you, they can all plug into the same app. It'll have the same lovely shiny black finish as well, so it's very appealing, very aesthetic. Samsung's just gone a little bit further and allowed you to plug it all into the same app. Do note the insulation, it all needs to be proper tough coat insulation, external weatherproof insulation. A lot of people will miss out on simple things like that, and simple things like that make a big difference overall, so please don't forget about them. Okay, so we've just been looking at the heat pump, which is just the other side of this window here. These are the internal gubbins that come with it. So a lot of people like to use pre-plumbed cylinders, so for the Mitsubishi products. Nothing wrong with that at all. We offer an alternative solution. So this is a non-pre-plumbed cylinder. This happens to be a 300 litre one. We then supply the pack to go with it. So you've got your buffer tank, which sometimes might be a low loss header, sometimes buffer tank, which just provides a bit of mechanical separation to the system. You've got your expansion vessel for the hot water, expansion vessel for the central heating. We don't supply the one for central heating, but we do supply the hot water one. We supply all the other gubbins in this kit generally as an installation pack to go with the cylinder. So, you know, it's not pre-plumbed, but we provide the kit to make it plumbable. This is a lovely install by one of our really good local installers. Doesn't necessarily have to be this beautifully neat, but it is a lovely job that they've done it. So this is what hopefully you'd be looking at. If you haven't done many heat pumps before, don't worry, we offer free training courses down at our place just down the way, or we do online ones as well. So if you don't make the journey down to us, then you know you can do an online course. So we can teach you how to do this on all your jobs. So if you're interested in attending one of our training courses, we'll put a link in the comments below. So just click on that link. It'll take you onto our website. You can see the list of courses available, book yourself on. They're free to attend. We do, if it's an on-site course, we do ask for a deposit, but that's refundable as soon as you attend. So yeah, do that, or pick up the phone to us. I believe our phone number will be in the comments too, or drop us an email, whatever works for you. Send us a pigeon, whatever, you know, whatever you want to get in touch, mate. Yeah, job's a good one. I just wanted to make a point. So this is where the pipes come through from the outside of the building to the inside, and just please note, you know, the insulation is carried on the whole way through. It's all in this tough coat external insulation. Obviously then when you come inside, you can switch to the sort of standard 19mm armor flex kind of thing. Just to make the point, please do insulate. Look at how well everything's insulated, cable tied on, nice and secure, nice and snug. It's not going to go anywhere. That's how it should be.